Let's wrap up this lesson. We've talked about three key ways to compute the value of a company: intrinsic value, which is based on future dividends. In other words, companies pay a certain amount to their investors every year based on how many shares they own. And this is the value of all future dividends going into the future. Book value, which is the value of the company if we split it up into pieces and sold those individual pieces. And finally, market capitalization, which is simply the value that the market is placing on the company. So many stock trading strategies look for deviations between, say, intrinsic value and market cap. If intrinsic value drops significantly and the stock price, say, is high, it might be worthwhile to short that stock. Or if, say, dividends are going up and the market capitalization is low, it might be an opportunity to buy the stock. And similarly, book value provides a sort of lowest price. When stock price begins to approach book value, you can pretty much assume that the price is not going to go below book value, or not much below it, because if it does, a predatory buyer would buy the whole company and break it up for parts. Anyhow, that's company valuation, and I look forward to seeing you at the next lesson. Bye-bye.